Alright, good morning everyone. It's Friday, April 5th, 2024. It is 5:22 a.m. I'm off on my way into work. I stopped at some jobs this morning, a little coffee on the way in. Stopped to get my co-worker Silas on the way in. A little stream snow today, a little shitty out. Everyone has a good, safe day today. Hope y'all stay warm, stay dry, stay cool, stay safe out there. Whatever y'all do together, stay safe. We're all in this together. I miss you, Mom. Honey, Dad, hope you have a good day at school today. Dad, I love you. I miss you. I'll see you. I'll see you when school gets out today. Dad, you're picking me up. You're taking your mamas for the weekend. I'll be picking you up from Mama's on Sunday, so Daddy loves you and misses you, so I'll be calling you at 7 p.m. tonight. I want you to have a good day, honey, and I want you to have a good weekend at Mama's. Right, gas station. Be right back out, guys. Got me half a tank of gas. Got me a large hazelnut coffee with the nut cream and sugar. On my way in to work. Get Silas up this morning. Straight today. I was going to take I-95, but I was going to go straight, takes to Water Ave. Checkpoint, right, the bicycle point here, would be Kelly from the Imperial Point. I just see Kelly. Which ain't too far from the TV. Coming right up in the light. So. good weekend this weekend. Everybody does something fun this weekend. I'll enjoy it, do something fun. I'm glad. April, if you're watching, I still don't miss you. I didn't care about you. I'm always going to miss you. I always didn't care about you because we're together for so long. But I will never, ever, ever care for or about the games that you played and the stuff and what you did. I will never care about that. Never care how you chose a drug addict piece of shit to be around. Dude, like, bullshit, how you chose him. It's been 2 years since we spoke now. Been close to 2 years. It's been a year since we actually spoke himself. Actually spoke, like a year ago we were talking a little bit. That's because you had court coming up. You want me to help you in court, and I told you I would. Told you I'd go to court with you and stop for your kidnapping charges that you had. And then we ended up not going to court because we didn't get dropped. I was going to go to court for you. Tell them, hey, this is what I see happening. No, I weren't going to lie for you like you were asking me to. When you're asking me to go lie for you, no, I'm not going to lie for you in court. I'm going to tell you, this is what I see happening. The kid's father was an asshole and stuff. We talked about that, we told him about that, how it led up to the kid running away, but. We also want to let them know how you put it in the kid's mind. You should run away, you should run away. You're going to have to deal with it again, run away. You'll jump, go here, jump in the dumpster, hide there. Call my brother, have him pick you up. You'll stay with him for a while, then go to my sister's house in Bangor. You keep going from place to place to place, but he can't find you. Yeah, well, they got her in trouble. Police came. The kid's father. He's an adult now. 18, no, 19 now. But he's an adult now, but at the time he was only 16. She was telling him to run and go and hide and shit like that. Trying to keep him away from the father. Because the two of them didn't agree on how he should be raising the kid. But it's on her, it's on between them two. I'm just gonna go to court. I'm the worst not gonna lie for you. I would have told her that, yes, she told the boy to go and hide the dumpster. Yes, she told the boy to do step by step. Yes, I would have explained it to her. She was asking her nephew to go to court and lie for her too, and he wouldn't go. She kept telling her no, she kept getting mad at you, mad at you. She was mad at her sister because her sister wasn't going like her own boy. Yeah. up and down the street hill, on to Ohio, wake up Silas for work. No.